Where are they? I know you're hiding them. Tell me where they are. Last chance. Tell me where they are.
Never.
Fine.
I don't believe in an America where the separation of church and state is absolute. The idea that the church can have no influence or no involvement.
Can I get a minute?
Yeah, of course.
Sorry things turned out this way, Stephen. Should be me in this room, not you. Dad always tried to raise us right, but guess you were the only one that really took it to heart. Wish I would have listened. So now I'm in trouble. You were right. Just what we're doing, what I'm doing, it's just sick. I've hurt a lot of people. Good people. I know it was wrong. I'm just sorry it took what happened to you to make me realize that. I'm breaking you out of here. Wait.
Pray about myself. Help the others.
You know what? I don't get it. All you had to do is take back what you said. You didn't even have to mean it. All this would have gone away. Just let me do this. I can make this right here.
Friend, I just won't buy your salvation, so not any more than paying your taxes will. You need to help others. This is the right thing to do. But remember, your debt has been paid in full. You've been forgiven. You just need to accept that.
No. Things I've done can't be forgiven.
You're a good man, Saul. Consummate professional. I know this is hard for you, but I trust you'll keep doing your job. This is for the best, you know. Your country will be forever indebted to the sacrifices you've made for the greater good. It takes brave men to do the things we do for God and country.
You people need to wake up. Our leaders don't worship God, they worship a flag. They tell you that your sins will be forgiven if you pay your taxes to the church and sit quietly like good little Christians. But it's a lie. We're not under that covenant anymore. but you fools buy right into it because you love it when the politicians quote scripture out of context and play it to your prejudices. Each man needs to ask for forgiveness on his own. Jesus wouldn't have us force the gospel on people at gunpoint. They're throwing people in cages and slaughtering them. Innocent people. People have never hurt anyone. And you're turning a blind eye to it because you disagree with their lifestyles or how they came to this country or their religion. These are the very people that Jesus spent much of his time loving. And most of you won't even stand up to defend them. Some have kept the faith, and they've paid for it dearly. But mark my words, even if you think I'm crazy, there's gonna come a night when you'll wake up staring down the barrel of a rifle. And when that night comes,
there isn't going to be anyone left to help you.
stay.